Nick Korniloff. I'm the executive vice president, partner, and director of the Art Miami businesses. Well, a regular day for me starts very early, calling clients who are based in Europe, or it can go very late in the evening, calling clients that are based in Asia. But essentially, my duties within the business are to run the day-to-day operations, be the face of the business, interface with all of my directors in the different departments of the business, whether it's marketing, operations, but really focusing on the exhibitor recruitment of top-tier galleries to participate in all of our shows. I attended FIU University, received a degree in hospitality management and tourism, and then went to work for Spectacor Management Group over at the Miami Beach Convention Center. And I started out as an event manager, and the first day I stepped into the job, they handed me a walkie-talkie and said, go down to Exhibit Hall D and introduce yourself to the people of Art Miami. So the very first day, I worked on Art Miami back in the early 90s. And from that position, I became the facility manager, working on over 300 events a year at the convention center for about 3 or 4 years. I then left the convention center and went to work at Homestead-Miami Speedway to help bring in the first NASCAR Winston Cup event, work on Indy racing, selling sponsorships for that, and hospitality, corporate hospitality, and then received a call one day from the previous owners of Art Miami, who had sold their business to the Daily Mail Group out of London. And so I went and I interviewed to be the director of operations of that business, and went up to Palm Beach and started running fairs in Palm Beach, both a contemporary show and a very fine art fair, which was on level. We built it to be the most important fine art fair in America, and did that through 2007, and then came down to Miami in 2008, took over the directorship of Art Miami, and in 2009 bought the business with two partners. Well, I think being in the restaurant business teaches you a lot of different skills. First, you have to greet people. You have to look them in the eye, welcome them, be very open, be caring and understanding. One of the most intimate things you could ever do for another human is to feed them or to celebrate an occasion of theirs that's important to them. And so, you know, being open, learning how to service people correctly, and multitasking. I do that every day in my job. And all the jobs that I've had really have brought me to this point where I feel a very strong skill set, both promoting, marketing, operationally, finance, and all the different hats that you will wear in a day-to-day business. But it all boils down to customer service and relationships, and that's what our business is about. I feel like the art fairs are probably one of and the exhibition business as a whole is one of the last frontiers, so to speak, where people can engage each other face-to-face, get immediate reactions and judgments regarding whether it's products you're selling for a standard exhibition, but in our world, artists' creativity and getting that reaction from first-time viewers of that artist's work, or more of a historical approach from museum professionals, curators, and collectors of some of the best known artists, and hearing their take on how important a piece of work is immediate gratification, and that happens in a community, in a fair environment. So that's what I love most about my job. The exhibition business, particularly around art fairs, has grown exponentially because of the digital market. The ability to, you know, it used to take a while to FedEx a photo to another country and, you know, do you like this picture? Nowadays, you know, you come to an art fair and everybody is working their images back to the collector immediately, and you're able to go across the world globally. The globalization of the art market has grown side by side with technology. So it's been a positive. It's a business of trust. It's a business in which there has to be education involved. You don't just step into an art fair and buy a very important piece of work without not taking the time to learn about the artist, figure out a little bit more about the collection that you want to build or which you want to invest in. People buy and invest in art for all different reasons. Many just for the pure love that they have to have it, others because they want a return on investment. So you're never really sure if you're an exhibitor in the stand. You first and foremost never judge a book by its cover. And you have to be willing to have that moment of meet and greet and education. And that's what we do at the art fairs. We're very tied into the cultural fabric of Miami's community. Art Miami benefits the Perez Art Museum. We've worked with many other different organizations that support the arts here locally, Locust Projects in particular, the Wynwood Art District, we're very fond of. We work with the Art Dealers Association there. The Art Wynwood Fair benefits, the opening night benefits, the ICA Museum. So we're very tied in, so to speak, to the cultural fabric of the community. Art Wynwood event, you always have to, for me, I have to go back to the roots of why it was created. And it happened over a nice lunch between myself and Tony Goldman, who's a very dear friend of mine, and the Goldman family, who I just love. And what they've done for our community, with many others, to help put it at the epicenter of not just the cultural world, but also the business world, has been phenomenal, and including hospitality, which I'm very fond of. This fair was created to show the world that Art Miami and what happens during the month of December, while it's as wonderful as it is, this is the busiest weekend in South Florida. And this is kind of the second bite of the apple, Art Wynwood, for those who love to collect art. They can come this weekend and buy great works of art from some of the masters of the modern post-war pop era and some of the new, more emergent, mid-career, cutting-edge artists that are out there living. And it was also to brand Wynwood globally outside of that week in December and make sure that people who are coming to Miami are visiting the Wynwood Arts District, supporting the gallery system. There are plenty of important gallerists that live and operate here in South Florida, specifically in the Wynwood Arts District. That street art community, the works of art that are on example there, it's like no other place on earth. And so we infuse all of that together here at Art Wynwood. We have a little bit of a street art movement happening around some of, you know, your more classical artists like Miro. You'll find a Shepard Fairey or Ron English or a Retina around Lichtenstein and Warhol. So it's this great, showing how real-time collectors are living with all of the movements of the contemporary and modern art market. So that's what Art Wynwood's about.